what I hear about his life reflected in his kids and his grandkids. And so I think it's so nice that we can be together. I think it's an important thing to do, to be able to come together and be reminded of the gift that Carmine has been and forever shall be to us all. We know as Poppy, we know him as our dear dad, some of us Newt. You know, the many names that he's had in life, with every one of those lives, with every one of those, he's been able to draw people to him. His personality, his sense of humor. There are countless things that we can come here tonight remembering and be grateful for what we've been blessed to share with him. And so we come here together tonight as God's children, and we pray that all of us, as I trust that we are, can be instruments of God's peace in a time when we can really use and need to have our friends and our family around us. And so, to you, Dan and Shelley, to Joanna, Danny, and to Jimmy, to Vicky, to Caleb, in Brooklyn, we come here together tonight with and for you guys as we pray. As we pray and as we remember and we trust. We trust in where he is now, what he now receives and shares in the fullness of life. And he doesn't have to endure what we've watched him face. But dealing with cancer the past 4.5 years, but really enduring so much in the last few weeks. As he's undergone so much. And so he's at peace now, and may that give us some comfort, and may we come here tonight, and may we all forever be grateful for life shared with him. And so may we come here as God's children, may we mark ourselves with a sign that is hope, that is love, that has brought us here together in faith. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, may the grace peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with each one of you. My dear brothers and sisters, we come here tonight and we believe that all those things that bind us together throughout our lives, they don't unravel with death. And so confident that God remembers all the good that we know is done in life, forgives us of any of our sins, when you come here tonight, let us pray to gather, to receive, to welcome Carmine into the fullness of all that Jesus promises. Let us pray. Lord our God, the death of our brother recalls to each one of us the human condition of the brevity of our lives here on earth. But for all those who believe in your love, death is not the end. That you forge in our lives, for we share our faith in being called children of God, and we have hope in that always. Bring the light of Christ's resurrection to this time of testing and sorrow. As we pray tonight for Carmine, for all of his family, and all those that love him, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, we know that if our earthly dwelling, the tent, should be destroyed, we have a building from God, a dwelling not made with hands, eternal in heaven. We are always courageous, although we know that while we are at home in the body, we are away from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. Yet we are courageous, and we would rather leave the body and go home to the Lord. Therefore, we aspire to please him, whether we are at home or away, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each may receive recompense according to what he did in the body, whether good or evil. The word of the Lord.
There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff to give me courage.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want.
I have to say, there are so many reminders of why I love being a priest. To be with people at holy times like this. And I appreciate so much when you get to see such love as I have seen in your family and what you share. And what I've also found is there is so many memories that we cherish, times that we've had that we shall forever be grateful for, recognizing the impact and, you know, not the impression, the imprint that your dear puppy and dad has made on your lives. And it goes beyond. It goes beyond your family. It goes into growing up. And it has to do with where we come from. It has to do with a part of the community, the parish family, the Blessed Sacrament, and Roncalli, and it just goes on of places where we know that Carmine has been. And so much of what I heard has to do with loving and helping youth. And it's where he found himself. It's where he made great use of his gifts. It's where he, again, made lasting impressions on so many. And so tonight, as hard as it is, as we know our hearts weigh heavy, it's also a time that we are given to really be reminded and celebrate his life. Because when you think about it, he's accomplished much. Before we began, I went over and I was praying over his body and I said, you know what, you did so much beautiful. You did what you were came in this world to do. You put love to practice. And because of that, you see that being reflected, because nobody has witnessed that more so than you as dear children and grandchildren and all of us as friends. And so this is a time for us to remember just that. And as hard as it is, I know it can be, to come up and share, maybe not, some people, there's so much about his life that really makes us laugh because he was very funny. But there's also many times that we know that we are grateful for, and things that he's taught us about life and how to live it. And for that, I just would, I think that the Holy Spirit really touches our hearts at times like this. We are given what we need. So if anybody would like to come forward, family, friends, this is the time to do it. We would love nothing more to have you feel free. Now we are amongst here with family and friends. And so sounds like he wants to join us in the world too. You know? And so at this time, please come on up one at a time if you'd like to. We would love to have you do that. Thank you.
I'm John Bethune, and I'm from the earliest part of Carmine's life, Locust Valley, a very small, tight-knit community where it almost seems like everybody knows each other. Carmine was just a bright light. Even though he's been out here in Nebraska for many, many years, he is still part of our town of Locust Valley. And he is loved by so many there, and I'm here tonight and loved by so many here. I mean, the crowd just kept coming and coming and coming and coming. So I was also good friends with his older brother, Victor, and lost him a few years ago. I'm glad I got to come up and see Carmen a little bit about a month ago. What did we do? We just said we loved each other. Very simple. We gave each other a kiss of love. So Carmen, thank you for being in my life and all these people's lives, the family, and of course our hometown of Locust Valley.
Parking lot at 1:30 in the morning, seeing nothing but headlights, one direction, six lanes of, you know, 1:15 in the morning, I'm like, oh my God. Hearing Beastie Boys for the first time on the radio, that was, woo, that was interesting. That channel got turned quick. You know, and so we get off at the, you know, the Glen Cove exit where Gene's from, and only my dad, you know, would pull over a police officer at 1:30 in the morning now. Hey, how do you get to Locust Valley? And he looked at him and said, two blocks that way. Okay, you know, my dad, his ultimate wisdom thought we could just drive around Locust Valley and find Carmen Jean's house. But instead, we pull into this little Charlie's Pub, 1:45 in the morning, and we're gonna go and call Carmen and tell her in town. Well, then, 15, 20 seconds later, two guys come barreling out the door like it's a bar fight. It's my dad and Carmen's younger brother, Nicky, at the bar, 1:45 in the morning, and they're laughing. So my mom is in the front seat, my sister's right here, and we're looking like dad's about ready to get his, you know, what kicked, and we didn't realize that we didn't know it was Nicky. So after the short explanation and everything, and Nikki calls Carmen from the bar, and Carmen's like, hey, you ain't gonna believe who's here. Carmen's like, it's 1:30 in the morning, I really don't, who's here, you know? No, you need to know who's here. Nikki, I don't really care who's here. It's Rex and Diane. What? And I was, you know, of all places, you know, 1:45, you know, in the morning, you know, Long Island, New York, and Locust Valley, and we spent Thanksgiving together, and it was pretty cool when we found out that we're moving back. And ain't gonna lie, you know, it was 4th of July weekend, and you know, it was 4th of July, and we shot off fireworks when they came to town, because it was a celebration, the neighborhood was back, you know? As the Abates and Duranuses, we he wasn't an uncle, he wasn't just a friend, he was another dad that I shared with my three sisters and little brother. Super Bowl Sunday, take care of who was playing. Jeannie made the best lasagna in the world. I know you're eating it now. You must. I put up with you for 47 years, man. I wouldn't trade you even for the world. I said I wasn't going to cry anymore. I said I wasn't. I wish Kylie was here to tell her I can't say little pig suey, and I can't do that. Now he's back with the love of his life, and he's looking down at his four children and his grandkids. And his two son-in-laws. And he did it all the right way. A little strange sometimes, but he did it the right way.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. We also know that the prayers and the love that we receive from our parents are so powerful, and they help us to be the people that we are today. And I think it's so fitting and so right that we ask for prayers from our Blessed Mother. Her greatest desire for any of us is to know that there be peace in the presence of her Son Jesus in our lives. And so in a mother's love, that we may have an increase in faith, we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners now and at the hour of our death. Of faith within us all. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the increase of hope within us all. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for our sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Lock the gates of life for all those who believe in you. Forgive Carmine of any of his sins, and now grant him a place of happiness, light, and peace in the kingdom of your glory forever and ever. Amen. Blessed are those who died in the Lord. Let them rest from their labors, for their good deeds always go with them. Eternal rest be granted unto Carmine, O Lord, and let the perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace. Amen.
During this challenging time, we've done this once before with my mom and now with my dad, but there's peace of mind knowing that they're together again with the Lord. And we appreciate all of you that are here, all the people that came through. He would have loved it, because there was nothing he loved more than being around everybody. So thank you, everyone.